हेलो स्टूडेंट, लेट्स स्टार्ट टू लर्न स्टैंडर्ड 9th सब्जेक्ट साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, मीडियम इंग्लिश एंड सेम इंग्लिश मीडियम. यूनिट नंबर 1, लॉज ऑफ मोशन. टुडेज माय फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन. सेकंड पॉइंट इज लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मोमेंटम. थैंक यू. न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन. वी हैव लर्न अबाउट फोर्स and its effect on object through Newton's first and second law of motion. However, in nature, the force cannot be alone. Force is reciprocal between two objects. Force are always applies in pairs. When one object applies a force on another object, the latter object also simultaneously applies a force on former object. The forces between two objects are always equal and opposite. This idea is expressed in Newton's third law of motion. The force applied by the first object is called action force, while the force applied by second object on the first is called reaction force. Newton's third law of motion is, every action force has an equal and opposite reaction force, which act simultaneously. Now learn some example of Newton's third law of motion. When a bullet is fired from the rifle and the bullet exerts forces action and reaction on each other. These forces are equal in magnitude, opposite in the direction, and arises at the same time. The force on bullet imparts it high velocity, and force on the rifle make it recoil. That is, the rifle moves in the opposite direction compared to the velocity of the bullet. Second example, launching of rocket. When the fuel in the rocket is ignited, it burns as a result of chemical reaction, and the compressed hot gases are thrown out with a tremendous force in the downward direction through a small opening in the tail of the rocket. At the same time, the escaping gases exert an equal and opposite force of the reaction on the rocket in the upward direction. As this force is greater than the net downward force due to gravity and air resistance, the velocity of the rocket increases as it moves upward direction. Third example, hold a balloon, fill it with air, then release it. As air rushes down from the balloon, it is action, and the reaction is the balloon goes upward direction, in this direction. One, action and reaction terms that express the force. Second, these forces act in pairs. One's force cannot exist by itself. Third, the action and reaction force act simultaneously. Fourth, action and reaction forces act on different objects. They do not act on same object, and hence cannot cancel each other effect. Law of conservation of momentum. Suppose an object A has mass m1 and its initial velocity is u1, and object B has mass m2 and its initial velocity u2. According to the formula of momentum, the initial momentum of A is m1 u1 and initial momentum of B is m2 u2. Suppose these two objects collide. Let the force of A due to B f1. This force will cause acceleration in A and its velocity will become v1. So momentum of A after collision is equal to m1 v1. According to the Newton's third law of the motion, A also exerts an equal force on B, but in the opposite direction. This will cause a change in momentum of B. If its velocity after collision is v2, the momentum of B after collision is m2 v2. If f2 is the force that acts on object B, then f2 is equal to minus f1, m2 a2 is equal to minus m1 a1 because f is equal to ma, m2 into v2 minus u2 bracket complete upon t is equal to minus m1 into in bracket v1 minus u1 bracket complete upon t because a is equal to v minus u upon t. Then m2 in bracket v2 minus u2 bracket complete is equal to minus m1 in bracket v1 minus u1. M2 v2 minus m2 u2 is equal to minus m1 v1 plus m1 u1. So in bracket m2 u2 plus m1 v1 bracket complete is equal to in bracket m1 u1 plus m2 u2 bracket complete. The magnitude of total final momentum is equal to the magnitude of total initial momentum. Thus, if no external force is acting on two objects, then their total initial momentum is equal to their total final momentum. This statement is true for any number of objects. The law of conservation of momentum. When no external force acts on two interacting objects, their total momentum remains constant if does not change. This is corollary to Newton's third law of motion. The momentum is unchanged after the collision. The momentum gets redistributed between the colliding objects. The momentum of one of the objects decreases while that of the other increases. Thus, we can also state this corollary as follows. When two objects collide, the total momentum before the collision is equal to the total momentum after collision. In order to understand this principle, let us consider the example of bullet fired from the gun. When a bullet of mass m1 is fired from a gun of mass m2, its velocity becomes v1 and its momentum becomes m1 v1. Before firing the bullet, the both of the gun and the bullet are at rest, and hence the total initial momentum is zero. According to the above law, the total final momentum also has to be zero. Thus, the forward moving bullet causes the gun to move backward after firing. This backward motion of the gun is called recoil. The velocity of recoil V2 is such that m1 v1 plus m2 v2 is equal to 0, or v2 is equal to minus m1 upon m2 into v1.